subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures, and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. India is home to some of the most renowned tourist spots around the world. From the snow-clad mountains to the great heritage sites, the country has some of the most sought-after tourist destinations that are admired by citizens around the world. Surrounded by water on three sides, India is also well known for its beaches, whose scenic beauty is a visitor's retreat. Recently, one such beach from Puri has been awarded the Blue Flag certification for its conservation and sustainable development efforts. Take a look.
The world is very well acquainted with the scenic beauty of Indian beaches, which stretch through a vast coastline and attract a number of beach lovers around the globe. Indian beaches have a mass turnout of tourists who are often seen awestruck not just by the splendid beauty of the waters, but also with the cleanliness of beaches, which is a result of the collective efforts of both authorities and citizens. A number of beaches in India have been recognized by organizations around the world for the beauty, maintenance, and innovative ideas. Recently, the Puri beach of Odisha has been awarded the prestigious Blue Flag certification by a Denmark-based NGO for its efforts in environmental education.
Puri ro pavitra bela bhumi ko antarashtriya bela bhumi ro manyata jo blue flag beach kuha jaye seta milisi sethi pai mu samastan ko hriday ro shubhechha janauchi bahut bahut congratulations janauchi amaro ei beach ro manyata pai bela bhumi ro blue flag manyata pai jo jo sahajog deichanti je mane विशेष करी मोर पुरी वासी और मोर टीम राइट फ्रॉम मो बीच कैंपेन रु नहीं करी से मु बहुत बहुत कृतज्ञ और यहाँ को मेंटेन करवा दिग्रे आपन समस्तन करो कंटिन्यूड सहयोग मिलिबो सेटा मोर विश्वास
Also known as Golden Beach, the beach has got its name by the long stretch of golden sands that rest on its shores. Tourists and devotees who come to visit the famous Jagannath Temple in Puri make sure to visit the beach to adore its beauty. Not just officials, but local citizens were seen happy at this achievement. To celebrate this new feather in Odisha's tourism cap, Sudarshan Patnaik, a renowned sand artist of international repute, created a new sand art.
ये खुश लगा कि हमारा जो पुरी का गोल्डन बीच है उसको सिलेक्ट किया गया है ब्लू फ्लैग सर्टिफिकेशन के लिए। ये एक बहुत अच्छा इनिशिएटिव है क्योंकि हमारा जो बीचेस है उसको ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा हम लोग क्लीन रख सकते हैं और उसके साथ पर्यटन को भी और बढ़ावा दे सकते हैं। और मैं ज़रूर ये कंग्रेचुलेट करना चाहूँगा कि जो 8 बीचेस हमारा देश में सिलेक्टेड हुए हैं ब्लू फ्लैग सर्टिफिकेशन के लिए।
With the inclusion of the Golden Beach, India now has 8 beaches that have been accorded with the Blue Flag certification. The Blue Flag certification is given to a beach, marina or boating tourism operator and serves as an eco label. It is awarded to applicants who fulfill the environmental, educational, safety related and access related criterions. 8 beaches in India that have been awarded with this certification are Kappar in Kerala, Shivrajpur in Gujarat, Gogla in Diu, Kasargod and Padubidri in Karnataka, Rushikonda in Andhra Pradesh, Golden in Odisha, Radhanagar in Andaman and Nicobar Islands. With the certification of Odisha's Golden Beach with the prestigious Blue Flag tag, the state is expected to get a major boost in tourism.
Considered as one of the most popular Muslim pilgrimage centers, the Dargah of Ajmer Sharif houses the tomb of Khwaja Moinuddin Chishti, a holy saint who dedicated his entire life to the service of the poor and downtrodden. Today, the Dargah is visited by millions of devotees every year, irrespective of their caste and religion, making it an epitome of communal harmony.
Situated in the heart of Ajmer city in Rajasthan, at the foot of a barren hill, the Dargah of Ajmer Sharif is one of the most sanctified shrines in the country. Dedicated to the founder of Chishtiya order in India, namely Hazrat Khwaja Moinuddin Chishti or Garib Nawaz, the Dargah is venerated by the people of all religious communities. The saint has millions of followers across the country belonging to different faiths who visit the shrine every year and offer holy chadar and flowers to seek his blessings.
Irade roz bante hain banke toot jate hain wahi ajmer aate hain jinhe khwaja bulate hain ye wo darbar hai ki yahan pe mazhab aur millat ka koi baat nahi har dharm ke log yahan garib nawaz ki darbargah mein hazir dene ke liye aate hain उन अपने मन की मुरादें यहाँ से पा के जाते हैं कोई यहाँ से खाली हाथ नहीं जाता गरीब नवाज की दुआओं की बरकत से अल्लाह पाक हर चीज़ को नवाजता है यहाँ फकीरी भी मिलती है और बादशाह भी मिलती है यहाँ जो भी बादशाह रहा वो गरीब नवाज के दर पे हाजिर हुआ है और उसने यहाँ पे आके दुआएं की हैं और हम भी दुआ करते हैं कि अल्लाह पाक जो ये बीमारी दुनिया में आई हुई है जिससे लोग परेशान हैं हताश हैं और कितनी परेशानियाँ आई हुई हैं वबा से तो हम दुआ करते हैं कि इस वबा से इस बीमारी जो आई हुई है कोरोना नाम की इस बीमारी को दुनिया से ख़त्म हो जाए और दुनिया में अमन कायम हो जाए
Born in Chishti region of Afghanistan, the saint came to India in his process to teach mankind the high way of living and settled in Ajmer. His shrine was built by Mughals, which makes it a splendid piece of Mughal architecture that consists of various buildings, tombs, courtyards and dalans. Prayers in the form of namaz are offered every day inside Mehfil-e-Khana, which is a spacious hall inside the Dargah that was built by Nawab Bashir-ud-Dawla, Sir Asman Jah of Hyderabad, Deccan. The Dargah is believed to fulfill the wishes of its devotees, who, according to the tradition, tie a religious thread along Jannati Darwaza, a beautiful gate covered with silver metal. People of all faiths, regardless of their religion, creed, caste or gender, visit the revered site every year and offer their prayers to the holy saint.
हर धर्म हर जाति का लोग यहाँ अपने श्रद्धा और अकीदत से यहाँ आते हैं यहाँ आपको चादर चढ़ाने वाला आदमी मिल जाएगा फूल चढ़ाने वाला मिल जाएगा नारियल चढ़ाने वाला मिल जाएगा और गरीब नवाज के ऊपर जितनी 36 कौम हैं सभी आस्थाएँ रखती हैं और पूरे हिंदुस्तान में जितनी दरगाहें चाहे कश्मीर हो या बॉम्बे हो या महाराष्ट्र हो या गुजरात हो या आंध्रा हो या यूपी हो उत्तर प्रदेश हो सब दरगाहों की सबसे बड़ी दरगाह है, अजमेर की दरगाह है।
The glory of Ajmer Sharif has only increased with time, and today it marks an important place in the history of Ajmer. Visited by the people from diverse faiths and communities, the dargah has been playing an important role in strengthening the secular thread of our country.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
The Indian Air Force celebrated its 88th establishment anniversary with elaborated stunts and maneuvers with its air aerobatic team at Hindon Air Force Station. Various aircrafts including Apache, Mi-35 attack helicopters and Rafale jets were among others that performed to commemorate the day. Indian Air Force was established on October 8, 1932 as an auxiliary Royal British Air Force.
I would like to assure the nation that the Indian Air Force will evolve and be ever ready to safeguard our nation's sovereignty and interests in all circumstances.
Air Force Day was observed for the first time in 1932 when India was under British rule. At that time, the Indian Air Force was an auxiliary of the Empire. The Indian Air Force safeguards the Indian territory and has been pivotal in providing help during natural calamities like during the floods in northern Uttarakhand state in 2011.
Tourist influx in India's Taj Mahal city Agra has increased 25 to 30% since last month after the world famous white marble monument was reopened for public in September. India reopened its famed monument to love, the Taj Mahal, on September 21. Daily visitor numbers are capped at 5000 versus an average of 20000 before the pandemic. Tickets are only being sold online.
जैसे जैसे पर्यटकों की संख्या बढ़ेगी वैसे ही वैसे पर्यटन उद्योग को बढ़ावा मिलेगा। ताजमहल के आसपास जो लोग रहते हैं, जो ताजमहल से जुड़े हुए हैं, चाहे वो गाइड के रूप में हो, दुकानदार के रूप में हो, और वो सभी लोग इससे फ़ायदा उठाएंगे और हमें उम्मीद से बेहतर रिस्पॉन्स मिल रहा है। जैसे जब ताजमहल खुला था तो लोगों में हमें भी ऐसा लग रहा था कि अभी कोरोना काल चल रहा है, पर्यटक कैसे आएंगे, लेकिन धीरे 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 जैसे एक कहना चाहिए बड़ा ही ओवरवेलमिंग रिस्पॉन्स है यहाँ पे पर्यटकों का।
फेस्ड विद द डीपेस्ट इकोनॉमिक कॉन्ट्रैक्शन इन डेकेड्स, द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया इज पुशिंग टू फ्री अप वायरस कर्व सो दैट जॉब्स एंड बिजनेसेस कैन रिज्यूम। लोकल बिजनेसेस दैट आर डिपेंडेंट ऑन टूरिज्म आर हैप्पी विद द टर्न अप। दे से द टर्न अप इज बेटर देन एक्सपेक्टेड। However, they understand that the situation will not return to normal until international flights are resumed.
Potters in Varanasi city of Uttar Pradesh are busy a bit too early ahead of Hindu festival of lights, Diwali, as they are getting an overwhelming demand for local-made earthen lamps as compatriots boycott Chinese products in the country. The Indian markets have a huge influence of inexpensive Chinese products, especially electronics and plastic items like toys or decoratives, which are even more prominent during the festive season. However, a call for boycotting of Chinese products grew larger in India after a bloody clash in northern Ladakh territory in June this year.
हर साल चाइना का माल आता था, उसमें झालर बत्ती प्लास्टिक का दिया आ जाता था, ये सब से तब हम लोगों का कोई खींच नहीं होता था, लेकिन इस साल जो है कि बंद हो गया है चाइना का माल, इसलिए दिया हुआ का जो आर्डर मिल रहा है हम लोग अपना उसमें कार्य कर रहे हैं।
Diwali, the festival of lights, is celebrated every year in October-November, where Hindus worship and decorate their homes with lamps and lights. It is believed that the Hindu goddess of wealth, Lakshmi, comes to those houses that are well lit and clean.
Authorities in Srinagar city of Jammu and Kashmir cleaned the pristine Dal Lake to make it a pleasant sight for the tourists that are expected to descend into the valley in the coming months as the government eased lockdown restrictions. The cleanup operations are conducted every year to clean the lake polluted by increasing encroachments in the valley.
अब जबकि टूरिस्ट भी आ रहे हैं यहाँ पर, थोड़ा थोड़ा ये विंटर्स ऑटम सीजन है और हम डल को पूरा ज़्यादा ही साफ करने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं, रखने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं।
एवरी ईयर टूरिस्ट फ्रॉम डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ इंडिया एंड द वर्ल्ड थ्रोंग द लेक टू एंजॉय राइड्स ऑन द फेम्ड शिकारा बोट्स। हाउएवर द कोरोना वायरस पैंडमिक हैज कैप्ट टूरिस्ट ऑफ द वैली दिस ईयर। Workers were employed to undertake the cleaning drive of the lake, the beauty of which has been marred by the filth floating on the water and moss and weed growing inside it.
India is a country that carries in its abode incredible stories of peace and brotherhood. Visuals of a Muslim celebrating Diwali and a Hindu observing Eid often make rounds on social media here. Celebrating this unity and togetherness between various communities along with promoting a healthy lifestyle, a cycle race was recently organized in Srinagar city of Jammu and Kashmir. Have a look.
Carrying the message of peace, brotherhood and happiness, around 500 youngsters in Srinagar pedal their way on the banks of Dal Lake. Named as Pedal for Peace, the race was organized by Jammu and Kashmir Police and was first in more than a year following months of restrictions after the revocation of Article 370 in August 2019 and then COVID-19 induced lockdown from March this year in the valley. Along with promoting the spirit of together, the event also aimed to inculcate a healthy lifestyle among youngsters as they are the future of nation as well as the change makers.
I'm very sure that these activities not only promote a spirit of togetherness, they also, you know, promote good health and they also promote good habits. You said drug abuse. Yes, definitely these kind of activities which take you towards positivity will definitely discourage the use of drugs and all. This is definitely a right kind of step in this direction.
The event included races for sub-junior boys and girls, junior boys and girls, senior men and women, and veteran men. The Union Territories Lieutenant Governor Manoj Sinha was the chief guest during the event. He appeared all enthused to witness such a huge participation of youth, later distributed prizes among winners at Police Golf Course in Srinagar.
It's very good, it's feeling fresh and it's good for our health and we can appreciate it because it's good.
Events like Pedal for Peace not just play a crucial role in creating awareness about health but also help in strengthening the bond of oneness among people no matter which caste or community they belong to.
There are numerous instances when social media has come to the rescue of those in distress and has done wonders with its power. A similar case is hogging limelight at present. This time, it's an octogenarian couple from New Delhi who was struggling to earn a livelihood amid pandemic. But when a food vlogger posted their video on social media, life was no longer the same for them the next day. So, let's take a look at how social media changed the couple's life from tears to cheers.
A swarm of people at a small food joint Baba Ka Dhaba at a busy New Delhi road is a subject of interest and a source of joy to the octogenarian owners of the store. A constant sound of Baba, a term of endearment to the elderly, is heard from the customers extending their hands with a currency note asking for a meal. Baba patiently listens to all and serves his delicacies with a smile to the eager customers. But this was not the situation for the elderly couple Kanta Prasad and his wife Badami Devi few days back, when they were struggling to have at least 5 customers a day. In a video posted by food vlogger Gaurav Vasan, 84-year-old Prasad was seen teary-eyed narrating his ordeal at deserted stall. He was telling Vasan how they were not even able to meet the input cost because of the prevailing pandemic situation and subsequent lockdown in the country. The video soon started trending on almost every social media platform in the country and public support started pouring in.
फेसबुक पे मैंने एक वीडियो देखा था तो बाबा रोते हुए दिखाई दिए थे. मैंने बाबा वाकई परेशान होंगे, मैंने एक बार मिल के जरूर आना चाहिए. तो मैं आया था, कल भी आया था, आज भी आया हूँ. और बाकी में बाबा का खाने में बहुत टेस्ट है, कल भी मैं खा के गया था.
बट अभी रात को ट्विटर में देखा कि बाबा का ढाबा और सबको इतना बाबा को हेल्प करे, तो फिर हम लोगों से रानी का सुबह होती मॉर्निंग 9 बजे का इंतजार कर और हम लोग भी यहाँ पे आ गए.
Today, Prasad is an overnight star. Several brands, including that of Pepsi, also came and advertised with him. Some are sponsoring his t-shirts, some his signboard, and others have also installed a payment gateway free of cost for him. Delighted with the response, Prasad says that he feels like whole India is standing with him.
हम बहुत महसूस कर रहे हैं कि आज हमारे साथ पूरा हिंदुस्तान है, सब लोग बड़े हैं, हर कोई हमारी मदद कर रहा है.
Along with the octogenarian couple, social media has also turned out to be a savior for a 90-year-old man in Agra city of Uttar Pradesh. Running a small stall of a dish named Kanjivara for almost 40 years in the city, Narayan Singh was not able to earn even a meager amount in a day amid the pandemic. But when a food blogger named Dhanishta shared a video of him where she told the location and all details of what elderly man sells, a number of people started queuing up at his stall the very next day.
मैंने ये वीडियो वायरल इसलिए किया था बिकॉज मैंने बाबा के ढाबा की वीडियो देखी थी, तो मुझे यही लगा था कि हमें अपनी लोकेलिटी में सबकी हेल्प करनी चाहिए. इसलिए मैं जिनको जानती थी मैंने उनके बारे में पोस्ट कर दिया. अगर मुझे और भी लोगों के सजेशन आएंगे कि जैसे इनको हमारी जरूरत है, तो मैं सबके बारे में पोस्ट करना चाहूंगी.
These two instances have proved that the power of social media is unmatched, and now the netizens are rallying together to help the street vendors across India.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@ANIN.com. I'm your host Shreya Savijay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.